News of the king's death was announced to us yesterday morning.
This young woman had a massive responsibility put on her at a time when she's grieving and she's had a terrible loss, the death of her father. And then her whole life changed.
Becoming queen at such a vulnerable age brings a set of responsibilities which then makes the subsequent conducting of a marriage or any family relationships incredibly difficult.
We are putting the audience at the heart of this family and the crisis and the trials and the tribulations and the struggle of the family and their relationship to government. So it's not just the story of a family, but the story of post-war Britain.
Be firm, just lay down the law. I know he's Winston Churchill and all that, but remember who you are. You're
nobody.
The Queen of England.
They're brilliant at going out in public, the Queen particularly, and wearing the mask of the Queen. But I think what our series does is it strips it away. And we get to see them be human and exposed.
Are you my wife or my queen?
I'm both.
I want to be married to my wife.
It's a series that goes right into their lives and into their relationships. The monarchy and politics are just this vast backdrop to a very intense and very personal story.
Why was government not consulted?
Because it's a private matter.
Nothing you or His Royal Highness do is a private matter.
It goes into a reality which we've never seen before. We've never seen behind those closed doors. Seeing the relationships and the humanity of these people is something that hasn't been done before.
Just remember who you're standing in for when I'm gone. My characterless sister. Your queen. Not a showgirl.
We try to capture as much reality as possible. And doing that means that you have to get all the costumes right, all the uniforms, all the detail. And I think that the scale of it on screen proves the ambition of this show.
It needs scale, it needs the extras, you know? It needs great costume design, which it has. It needs the wonderful locations, and it needs that sort of wowness to it. But beneath all of that, there are all these stories and little intricacies happening everywhere, and they all lead back to what is the purpose of the crown.
Never let them see the real Elizabeth Windsor. Never let them see that carrying the crown is often a burden.
I have seen three great monarchies brought down through their failure to separate personal indulgences from duty. You must not allow yourself to make similar mistakes. The fact is, the crown must win. Must always win.
But where does that leave me?